And welcome back to Sponsored September. I have more sponsors than usual this month, and it's all because of you guys. Thank you so much for supporting me, watching my content, liking, subscribing, all of that. It helps my dreams to come true, and I really appreciate you. So with that, let's move on to the sponsor. Today's video is sponsored by NordVPN. If you're curious what a VPN is, it stands for Virtual Private Network, and it creates a secure connection between your device and the internet. It encrypts your data traffic and changes your IP in the process. With a VPN connection, you can enjoy your digital privacy and online security and change your virtual location so that you can surf the internet without any restrictions. I know it sounds very complicated, but it's not. It is not as complicated as it sounds. All you have to do is connect with one click or use the automatic connection function to protect yourself without having to do anything. Now, I know you may be asking yourself, there are so many VPNs on the market, why should I go with NordVPN? Well, because it has the fastest speed out there. And not only that, but NordVPN is a double VPN, meaning your traffic is routed through two servers. That's called a double encryption. TV and movie buffs, don't miss out on your favorite content. With one click, you can have access to shows or streaming platforms from almost anywhere in the world. And gamers, I'm looking at you. Did you know that with NordVPN, you can download games that aren't available in your country? Just change your virtual location and download. So if you want to surf the web safely and get access to content all over the world, try NordVPN. Go to nordvpn.com/AmyK and get a 2-year package plus 4 additional months with a huge discount. And with that, thank you so much to NordVPN for sponsoring this video, and let's get on to it. Sunday, September 12th, 4:30 p.m. I will begin my analysis of the symbiotic relationship between the specimen and the host. The patient's vitals are steady and normal. I have contained and sedated the patient for their safety as well as mine. It has been several months since the symbiote was discovered on the meteor during the exploration mission in space. We brought them back here to Life Industries, and unfortunately, we have lost all but 3. The symbiote refuses to bond with any inorganic life forms, as well as bodies that have been vastly chemically altered. Symbiotes cannot survive without oxygen-breathing hosts. Unfortunately, it is often fatally rejected, resulting in the loss of the patient as well as the specimen. This case is very special. And that neither has rejected the other. I will examine the patient to see what it is that is different in this special case. I will begin my examination by checking motor functions and see if the symbiote responds to touch. All right. I will begin by touching various areas of the patient's face. There doesn't seem to be any reaction to touch. It may be because the patient as well is under sedation. Does it perhaps also affect the specimen? Going to feel the muscles of the patient. See if anything feels off. Checking the throat area, the lymph nodes for any inflammation. They are normal size, nothing seems to. Right, and breathing are fine. Temperature doesn't seem to be affecting their body. Muscles feel normal. Going to examine their eyes next. I'll open their eyes. Don't trust. We need to find the light. I think I saw something. Like that. No, I don't like that sound. May have noticed some movement, but not from the eyeballs. Going to check the other eye. No response from the patient. They are fully sedated. Seems to be a black substance in the capillaries. realize.
Shut up. Specimen seems to be traveling through the blood vessels in the face and is following the light. Is it responding to light? Also seems to be following my finger. I repeat, it is following the movement of my finger. Is this an attempt at communication? Finger over the light. Strike that. It is now following the light over my finger. Responsive. I'm going to try to poke the areas of the face, which it seems to be concentrating in. Okay. It seems to run. We'll move on to checking the ears. See if sound. It is very easy to see with its black, almost metallic look underneath the skin. Vitals are still normal. Using sound. Seemed to have a bit more movement with the higher sounds. Could it be possible that these symbiotic thoughts and feelings it seems to be tracing. Move on, checking how it responds to cold. And water. It doesn't seem to be averted to the sounds. No, I was not expecting it to, but these are chilled, and I will now check how it responds to positively, it seems.
That's what I'm kind of giving up to me too.
It looks like the face of the patient. To stop that experiment. The vitals are still very healthy. Almost too healthy. Interesting heart rate.
Is... You need to get out of it. You need to wake up. You need to
very good for someone.
Move the body. You need to wake up.
Such as this. Heart rate of Olympic athlete. Interesting. I'm going to continue seeing how it reacts to sound. Seeing as it seems to react mostly to higher pitches, I'm going to start with the higher pitch range with the tuning fork. Lower tone. Very little reaction from that one. But it does seem to react to sound. That's going to test. So I'm going to continue with various different sounds. Continue with more crinkles, do you see? Oh, it seems to react. And it is dancing around across. To gently tap on the glass of a jar. I do not want to anger it, so I will stop. Lastly, I want to see how it responds to heat. It responded positively to the cold. Patient feels cold, so I wonder. include body examination.
Move the body. Don't wake up.
Just in case. This creature is, it has quite the aversion to heat. I will write this down in my findings. Five PM. I am concluding tonight's analysis. I will write down my reports for my superior, and we will continue the analysis once the patient wakes up.